In Fox 5 Health News, SUNY Purchase in Westchester has reinstated its indoor mask mandate as COVID cases are spiking.
All right, join us now, Dr. Serge Sugar, Chief of Infectious Diseases at Holy Name Medical Center. Doctor, can you weigh in on this? It's probably a good idea. I guess the big thing is going to be how many people will comply with it, right?
That's right, Steve. So, you know, thanks for having me, Steve and Tasha. You know, do I foresee a mask mandate across the board? No, I think we need to understand what's going on. This is not unexpected. The so-called tridemic, we've been talking about it for some time. A large incidence of both influenza, mainly influenza A, RSV, as well as COVID-19. And we're certainly seeing that across the United States. About 14% of all Americans live in an area deemed high prevalence and transmission of COVID-19. So I think, and what I counsel patients, my colleagues all the time, what I do every day as an ID doctor is really imploring people to be fluid with their thinking and evolve as this pandemic has evolved. Obviously, we've been doing that now in year three. And so people really need to stop and take a look. A, are they, what's their transmission in the community that they live? Is it medium, low, or is it high? Again, like 14% of all Americans. And then look at individual risks, right? So if someone's very healthy, they're up to date in their vaccinations, both influenza and COVID-19, they're immunocompetent, that means they're not immunocompromised, they have an intact immune system, they don't have chronic diseases. Do I really think they need to wear masks all the time indoors? No. But you have to look at your own situation. Do you have a family member that you live with that may be compromised? Are you getting together for the holidays? Or are you truly immunocompromised? You know, are you receiving cancer treatments? Are you on chemotherapy? Are you on other medications that may preclude you from getting a good response to your vaccine? There's a lot of factors that go into play. And so what I advise anyone is always speak to their physician, understand their risks, the benefits, and then make the best individual decision based on all those contributing
Makes
factors.
Sense.
Yeah,
Makes sense.
And doctor, we wanted to ask you about the maker of Narcan seeking approval from the FDA to sell the overdose reversal drug over the counter. I mean, this is remarkable news. How could Narcan being OTC affect drug overdose survival?
So I'll tell you what, you know, working in the ER, we see this all the time. Just put in perspective, 80,000 Americans, that's a staggering number, died of opioid overdoses in this past year. That's both illegal, like heroin, as well as legal medications, prescription medications like fentanyl, Percocet, OxyContin, et cetera. So this is a very effective medication. It works in a matter of minutes. It can be given intramuscularly, or in this case, intranasally. Just a few puffs in each nostril can really be a lifesaver. What we do see is oftentimes opioid overdoses occur at home, so they're witnessed. And so if you have people that are well-trained and it's taken out of just the professional medical hands and given over-the-counter, we can really save a lot of lives. So now you have a drug manufacturer that has now gone to the FDA and applied for approval. And we're hoping this will really set the standard for other generic drug makers to also offer this, approved by the FDA, and has the potential to save many lives.
Yeah, it's such a crisis right now, all these accidental fentanyl overdoses. Yeah. You see it every day. All right, Dr. Serge Sugar, we appreciate it. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
All right, Nick is joining out with a look at the forecast. I'm looking at Thursday.